Hello, I'm Sebastian. Welcome to Nine Gnar Trees podcast. Today, I will summarize and review the book in Not the End of the World, How We Can Be the First Generation to Build a Sustainable Planet. Hannah Ritchie presents a refreshing, data-driven perspective on the global environmental crises. The book challenges the frequent doom-laden narratives surrounding climate change and sustainability, offering instead a hopeful yet pragmatic vision of the future. Ritchie, acclaimed for her work with Our World in Data, harnesses extensive research and empirical data to argue that with science-led approaches, humanity can overcome looming environmental challenges. This book seeks to empower readers, urging a shift from despair to proactive, informed action towards building a sustainable planet. I will give you key takeaways from this book. Firstly, the reality of climate change. Hannah Ritchie opens her discourse by detailing the current state of climate change, leveraging global data to paint a comprehensive picture. She clarifies common misconceptions, using factual evidence to highlight both the severity and the nuanced understanding of climate phenomena. Ritchie emphasizes that while climate change is an urgent issue, it is often misrepresented in popular media, leading to unnecessary panic rather than productive action. The discussion includes insights into global temperature rises, melting ice caps, and the increase in severe weather events, all underscored by scientific data illustrating trends and predictions. Her factual approach serves to educate readers about the importance of basing environmental policies and personal actions on robust scientific findings rather than hyperbole. Secondly, technological solutions for sustainability. One of the central themes of Ritchie's work is the role of technology in addressing environmental issues. She extensively explores innovative solutions like renewable energy technologies, carbon capture, and storage systems, and advances in agricultural practices that could drastically reduce human impact on the Earth. Detailed case studies of countries that have successfully integrated large-scale solar and wind power provide a blueprint for others to follow. Ritchie debates the potentials and limits of these technologies, offering a balanced view that considers both the technological optimism and the challenges that lie ahead. Her argument is buoyed by data showcasing the rapid advancements in these fields, suggesting a tipping point where sustainable technology becomes not only viable, but preferable. Thirdly, economic impact of environmental policies. Ritchie dedicates a significant portion of the book to dissecting the economic implications of environmental policies. By analyzing different economic models and historical data, she presents how sustainable practices can lead to economic resilience and growth. The discussion involves detailed analysis of the costs associated with unchecked environmental degradation versus the investments needed for sustainable practices. Furthermore, Ritchie highlights how green policies have led to job creation in new sectors, fostering economic diversification and innovation. Her pragmatic examination helps demystify the notion that there is a dichotomy between economic growth and environmental sustainability, showing instead how they can be mutually beneficial. Fourthly, global cooperation and policymaking. Ritchie stresses the importance of global cooperation in combating environmental challenges, drawing on examples like the Paris Agreement and the Sustainable Development Goals. She discusses the role of international organizations, national governments, and local communities in forming effective strategies and policies. Moreover, Ritchie points out the challenges and successes of current international policies, advocating for more robust, transparent, and inclusive environmental policies. Her analysis extends to the role of individual action and its impact on global policy, encouraging a more involved and informed citizenry who can hold their leaders accountable and drive meaningful change. Lastly, the role of individual responsibility. Ritchie concludes by examining the role of personal responsibility in mitigating environmental issues. She provides practical tips and strategies individuals can adopt, such as reducing waste, changing dietary habits, and supporting sustainable products and companies. This discussion is framed around the idea that individual actions, when multiplied across millions of people, can lead to significant environmental and social change. Ritchie uses data to inspire readers, showing examples of how small changes have led to large impacts in various contexts. This empowering message reinforces the book's theme that everyone has a part to play in building a sustainable planet. In conclusion, Hannah Ritchie's Not the End of the World, is a crucial read for anyone interested in understanding and acting on environmental issues with a balanced and hopeful outlook. It's particularly beneficial for policymakers, educators, and environmental activists looking for a data-driven approach to sustainability. The book equips readers with the knowledge and tools to make informed decisions, promoting a more sustainable lifestyle. For anyone feeling overwhelmed by dire environmental predictions, Ritchie provides a fresh, optimistic, and practical perspective that not only highlights the severity of the issues, but also the viable paths forward that can lead to real and positive change. If you would like to support Hannah Ritchie, you can buy the book through the Amazon link I've provided in the podcast description. After reading the book, please let me know what you think and share your thoughts. See you around.